Hello everyone. For today's topic, we are going to answer Quizzer Chapter 2, Multiple Choice of Answer Key, Learning to the Basics of Accounting by Rafael M. Lopez, 2020-2021 edition. Anyway, I have created a playlist for the rest of the answers relating to this book. Just click the link above. For the instruction, multiple choice, encircle or select the letter of the correct answer in each of the given question. Question number one. The period covered in this statement of comprehensive income may be? The answer is dog, all of the above. Why? Because in the time period assumption, we can actually use monthly, that's for every month. We could actually use quarterly, no, that's every 3 months. There is also semi-annual and annually, okay, calendar year or fiscal year. And we also have interim period. So if it's not equal to 1 year, if it's less than 1 year, like 11 months, so that's interim period. But for the question number one, the answer is dog. Question number two. The business has a continuous life of existence and it will continue to operate for an indefinite period of time. The answer is letter A, continuity or going concern assumption. The business has this assumption, huh? Now, once it operates, it is being assumed that it will continue to operate in a foreseeable future. Why? Because in accounting, different po ang treatment sa business na mag-i-stop na ng operate. At different ang treatment sa business that will continue to exist in a foreseeable future. Yes, it may be true that business may not indefinitely exist. But that is just an assumption. No? Isa yan sa mga rason kung bakit nagbabay ng equipment ang company is hindi in-expense agad. Nare-record pa siya as asset, then as time passes by, we recognize depreciation expense every period. Kasi once you assume na ang business ay pang 1 year lang or 6 months lang, once nagbabay sila ng long-term asset, automatic expense na yun. No? So it becomes a different accounting treatment. Pero who would assume, no, na magbi-business ka tapos hindi pala magko-continue to exist? Okay? That is letter A, Apple. Question number three. The life of the business is divided into equal periods wherein at the end of each period, financial statements are prepared. The answer is letter C. Okay, yung A and B, same lang po yan, accounting entity concept or business entity concept. That concept means what? That the business and the owner, they are separate. Okay, so letter C, time period assumption, na yung financial statement ng company is divided into different periods. Okay, profit for 2018 is only for 2018. Profit for 2019 is profit for 2019. So that's time period assumption. Why we need to divide it into different periods? Because si BIR, hindi naman nag-collect ng tax at the end sa life ng business. But that is every period. Question number four. Which of the following item is not an underlying assumption in financial accounting? The answer is dog, matching. Why? Because in the GAAP, generally accepted accounting principle, divided po yan sa dalawa. We have the assumptions, accounting assumptions, and the accounting principles. For the accounting assumption, we have the first one, accounting entity concept. This concept means that the owner and the business, they are separate. Okay? So, iba po yung personal expense and business expense. Second assumption is going concern assumption. This is an assumption wherein a business will continue to exist in a foreseeable future. So, number three, time period assumption. This assumption means that the life of the business is divided into different periods. Unit of measure. Okay. That means what? Pag sa Philippines po, nag-prepare na tayo ng financial statement, that means yung mga amount na makikita mo dyan is that's peso. So, pag ang company ay may branch sa US, tapos naka-dollar, then kailangan pa yung i-convert ng peso to make it comparable. Okay? Next is we have accrual basis. Accrual basis po is the opposite of cash basis. Kasi yung cash basis is that nagre-recognize lang tayo ng income pag na-receive yung cash. Pero sa accounting po, we are using accrual basis. We recognize income when earned. For example, no, isa kang barbero. So, kailan ka magre-recognize ng income? Yung time na natanggap mo na ang pera? Or yung time na nakarender ka na ng service? Okay, sa accrual basis, yung time na nakarender ka na ng service. That means, kung isa kang barbero, yung time na tapos ka nang naggupit, kahit hindi ka pa binayaran, income na yon. So, i-recognize natin yan as accounts receivable. Unlike yung isa, cash-based, yung naka-receive ka ng cash, tapos hindi ka pa naka-render ng income, ng service, hindi pa yon income, no? Liability pa yon. Ang tawag natin dyan is unearned income. Yung ikalawa is that principles, no? The first principle is cost principle. That means what? Yun pong nagbabay tayo ng land, i-re-record natin yan sa ating financial statement at cost, kung magkano ang bili natin. No, yung land kasi is nag-a-appreciate, di ba? Habang tumatagal, tumataas yung value. Pero, that would what? Give room for fraudulent financial reporting. Kaya, we are using what? Cost principle. Kung ano yung cost, yun yung ilagay natin sa financial statement. Second is objectivity principle. So, being objective is the opposite of being subjective. Being subjective meaning based on feelings, right? So, being objective means what? We prepare reliable information based on facts. Number three is materiality principle. So, ito yung rason kung bakit may mga item na nire-recognize, may mga item na hindi nire-recognize. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng materiality? No? Pag may effect siya sa decision-making, material yun. Okay. For example, yung 100 pesos, material na yun sa atin. No? Parang malaki na yun sa atin. Pero kung para kay Manny Pacquiao, immaterial yun. Parang barya lang yan. So, ibig sabihin, pag ang sari-sari store nawala ng 1,000 peso, material na yun. Pero kung 1,000 peso ay nawala kay San Miguel Beer Corporation, parang barya lang. So, that more or less, no, that's materiality principle. Isa sa mga rason kung bakit may mga item na nire-recognize at hindi. Number four is adequate disclosure principle. So, when you say adequate disclosure, that means what? Any information po na may effect sa decision making ay dapat nilalagay, dini-disclose sa notes to financial statement. For example, ang isang investor nag-invest siya dahil nakita niya ay grabe yung profit sa company. Pero hindi dinisclose na for this year ay nasunog pala yung planta. So meaning, dapat any information na may effect sa decision making, dini-disclose para fair sa mga user ng financial statement. Next is matching principle. Matching principle is the combination of revenue recognition and expense recognition. No? Ibig sabihin, pag nagre-recognize ka ng income, may kaakibat yung expense. No? Matching. We match revenue with expense. Okay. Then we have consistency principle. So may mga iba't ibang method sa accounting, pero kung ano yung napagpasyahan ng company na method na gamitin, like weighted average method sa inventory, so dapat consistent na yun para comparable, no, sa next accounting period. Pero ano yung hindi assumption out of the four? Matching. Kasi matching is not an assumption but a principle. Okay? Question number five. The underlying concept serves as the basis for preparing financial statements at regular interval. So that means time period. That means the life of the business is divided into different regular interval. Number six, the financial report that are prepared in less than a year. Okay. Sir, di ba quarterly less than a year naman yan? Pero specific yan na every 3 months. Okay. So that's why the answer is interim. So any po financial statement na hindi aabot ng 1 year is an interim financial statement. So meaning yung quarterly is just under the term interim financial statement. Okay, so just like hindi pa 12 months, 11 months pa lang, so magpe-prepare na. Question number 7. A person who borrows money from a bank to start with a business and treats his borrowing as capital rather than a liability is under what concept? So the answer is letter A. So the only option here na pagpipilian mo is letter A, apple, and D, dog. Pero yung business entity is the opposite of proprietary theory. Business entity means what? The owner and the business, they are separate. So pag personal expense mo yan, like kumain yung family mo sa labas, hindi yan expense ng business. Or else, pag i-expense mo siya sa business, you will not show the true performance of the company. Okay? So that is business entity concept that the owner, personal matter, and the business matter, they should be separate. Pero yung proprietary theory is that the opposite, na there is no difference between the owner and the business. They are considered as one. Kasi kung ano yung loss at gain ng business, is affected naman si owner. Pero the answer is letter A. Why? When a person borrows money from a bank, okay, that will be treated as a personal liability. Tapos yun yung i-invest niya sa business as capital. Okay? So that's why that's business entity. Sir, bakit hindi sagot dog proprietary theory? Kasi pag proprietary theory, considered sila as one. Meaning, nag-borrow ng money, personal, tapos ginawa niyang liability sa business. So, treated sila as one. Pero dito kasi ginawa natin as siya as capital. Meaning, personal liability, kinonvert natin as capital. So, kaya A ang sagot. Number 8. Under the business entity concept, when a person starts with a business for the first time, his capital will be treated as, again, it's capital, not liability. So, A, apple. Number 9. A type of accounting information that concerns primarily in describing the financial resources, obligations, and activities of an economic entity resulting to the preparation of general purpose operating results. The answer is BOY, financial accounting. So financial accounting, nagpe-prepare tayo ng financial statement for external purpose. Okay? Sa management accounting kasi, that's for internal purpose. So, walang standard na fina-follow, any format will do. Pero for external purpose, we use financial accounting. Okay? Standard base. Number 10, the business activity that involves primarily in looking for resources of capital for the entity? The answer is BOY, financing activity. Why? Kasi meron tayong tatlong activity sa business. Operating activity, financing activity, investing activity. Wala pong structuring activity. Kailangan mo siya matatawag na operating activity. E bakit ba nag-ooperate si business? Kasi for profit. So ano bang main source ng profit? So yun, magbenta ng mga inventory, mag-collect ng mga receivable, gumawa ng, okay, bumili ng mga supplies, operating activity yan, no? Nagsusweldo kasi yung mga employee, operating activity yan. So, pag mga income statement transaction, mga current asset transaction, current liability transaction, operating activity yan. No? Sa B, financing. Dalawa lang source ng financing. It's either debt, debt po na utang, D-E-B-T, and equity financing. Pag anak ka ni Manny Pacquiao, of course, hindi ka na mangungutang. No? Kasi may enough capital ka na. So, ang tawag dyan, equity financing. Pero kung wala kang pera, hindi ka anak ni Manny Pacquiao, mangungutang tayo. So, ang tawag natin dyan is debt financing. So, financing activity means what? Ito yung mga activity nag-i-involve ng what? acquiring capital, no? Paano ba tayo makakukuha ng capital? Equity financing, meaning sarili kong pera, i-invest ko, or mangungutang ako, no? Sources of capital. The third one is investing activity. So this activity involves what? Mga non-current asset. May enough na tayong capital para sa para saan to? Okay, bili natin ng building. So meaning na mapapakinabangan natin ng building for more than siguro mga 5 years, long term. So pag involved siya ng mga non-current asset, investing activity yan. Okay, and the rest is operating activity. Okay, so the answer is boy. 11. The type of accounting information wherein it focuses in comparing actual against budgeted data and later makes the analysis of variance. The answer is management accounting. No, this is higher accounting na po, especially on the topic standard costing and variance analysis. Question number 12. Financial statements prepared are worth comparing with other companies of the same line of business by pointing out similarities and differences. We call that as comparability. 13. The user of financial statements who needs the information assessing the ability of the entity to pay dividends. Okay. Sino ba ang mas concerned sa dividend? The answer is boy investor. Yung letter A, lender, ang other term for ng lender ay creditor. Kung ikaw ay nagpapautang, ano ang mas concerned mo? Kung makakabayad ba siya. So meaning, ang concern mo as lender is liquidity. Pero kung ikaw ay investor, gusto mo pag-invest mo, ay may babalik ba sa'yo na ginansya. Okay? So, ang tawag po natin dyan, yung return is dividend. So pag-investor ka, ikaw ang may concern sa dividend. Sir, paano pag supplier ako? Ano ang concern ko? Mas concern mo yung stability ng company. Yung continuity ng company. Bakit? Kasi supplier ka, what if nag-shutdown 1 year after? Eh, wala ka nang susupplyan. Okay? Pero lahat sila ay may concern sa financial statement sa company. Iba-iba lang yung interest nila. Kung public ka, sir, ano naman ang concern ko sa public? Sir, concern mo yung CSR ng company, corporate social responsibility ng company. May iambag kaya to sa society? Okay, and so on and so forth. So the answer is boy. 14. One of the disadvantages of a sole proprietorship as compared to other forms of business organization is that the answer is all of the above. So A, that's part. Sole proprietor cannot allow salaries for himself. So sole proprietor, ang tawag sa owner pag sole proprietorship. That means sole proprietorship meaning isa lang yung owner. Ikaw lang, ayaw mo ng kakampi sa trabaho. So, ikaw lang mag-isa, you own your own business, wala kang partner. You cannot allow salaries for yourself. Bakit? Sa partners kasi, pwede yung salaries. Kasi iba-iba naman yung ambag ng bawat partner, di ba? May partner na ganito ang ambag. May partner na nagmamanage. May partner na nag-i-invest lang, walang ginagawa. So, yung nagmamanage, bigyan natin ng salaries kasi iba-iba yung contribution. Sa sole proprietor, ikaw naman yung may-ari. So kahit magbigay ka ng salary sa iyong sarili, the remaining is sa'yo pa rin mapupunta. So parang kahit may salaries or wala, sa'yo naman lahat yan. Okay, so hindi mo binibigyan ng salaries ang sarili mo. B, when there is loss, he has to shoulder everything. Yes, no? Ikaw lang yung owner, ikaw lang ang mag-shoulder ng everything. Pag profit, din sa'yo lang rin lahat. Letter C, he is to provide his own capital. Yes. Sir, pwede naman siyang mangutang. Yes, yan yung punto ng statement. Limited lang yung capital mo sa capacity mo to invest or yung capacity mo mangutang. No? So, all of the above. 15, the capital of our corporation is called share capital. Okay? Katulad na lang ng Jollibee. Sir, paano ba makaka-raise ng capital ang Jollibee? Nag-i-issue sila ng share. Okay? Ang tawag natin sa Jollibee, stock corporation. For profit po sila. Stock is a Philippine term, while share is an international term. So, anong sasabihin ng Jollibee? Gusto namin mag-open ng new branch. Gusto namin ng more capital. So, anong gagawin nila? Magbebenta sila ng share. Okay. Benta kami ng share. Public, sinong gusto bumili? Okay. Once ikaw, interesado ka, so pwede ka bumili ng share sa Jollibee. So, ang tawag sa'yo, pag bumili ka, ay shareholder. International term, pwede ring stockholder, Philippine term. Pero ang tawag sa capital mo, pag once bumili ka ng share, is share capital. 16. The shares in profit of a shareholder is called? The answer is dividend. No? Yan po yung rason kung bakit nag-i-invest ang isang investor to get dividend. 17. The maximum number of years that a corporation may exist? Sir, di ba marami namang company na more than 100 years na? The maximum life of a corporation is what? 50 years, no? It's just that pwede mo siyang i-renew 5 years bago ma-expire. But the maximum life pag hindi mo ni-renew, 50 years. Renewable lang siya. Kaya pwede na ring indefinite, pero 50 years yung sagot. 18. Cooperatives are registered with, okay? All cooperatives are registered in this agency. We have the CDA, Cooperative Development Authority. And question number 19, what do you call the term used to describe the profits of a cooperative? So kung dividend ang tawag sa corporation, ano ang tawag sa cooperative? Net surplus. Now, dinidivide po yan according sa kanilang proportionate na naiambag sa cooperative. So the answer is net surplus. Kasi yung net profit, net income, lahat po yan sa corporation. Okay. So that's it for today. That's Quizzer Chapter 2, Multiple Choice, Learning the Basics of Accounting by Rafael M. Lopez, 2020-2021 edition. If you want to know the rest of the answers relating to this book, just click the playlist above. Thank you and God bless.